But I was a youth. And they were asking for information. And I didn't know what to say, but I just say, God knows, Mama. God knows. We will pray, God knows. And you know what surprised me was she came to church and testified. That I met with the youth chairman. And I told him my story and he encouraged me.
Interesting.
It was interesting, yes. So, as a young man, do something. Do something. Amen. You must be a young man who is doing something, not just sleeping. Amen.
Amen.
Now, tonight I have been assigned to speak about deliverance. Deliverance as
Amen.
A youth.
Amen.
Youth deliverance as a young man. Deliverance is to be rescued from danger. Where there was supposed to be danger, where there was supposed to be something to give harm to your life, and then you are rescued and taken out of that thing, then you have been delivered. Now, as we are saying every time, you remember, those who know, I always tell you that we have been saved, we are being saved, and we are going to be saved. Our spirit was saved. Our soul continues to be saved. And our flesh shall be glorified.
That's right.
When we are being saved, the final salvation is for glorification. When I was told that God come and preach deliverance, something just ring in me, and that there is a doctrine that goes around. Which tells people, and young people are dying because of that doctrine. When you get born again, there are things that happen. Because the devil wants to continue harnessing you and cause you to be to continue doing the wrong things that you have been doing, but he will give you a refined way of doing it. Come on, let's go to the word of God quickly. The book of Matthew, chapter 16. Matthew chapter 16. Verse number 21. Matthew chapter 16, verse number 21 up to 26, I will read. From that time forth began Jesus to show unto his disciples how that he must go unto Jerusalem and suffer many things of the elders and chief priests and scribes, and be killed and be raised again the third day. I don't like this version. Let me go to another version. I want the Amplified on this one. Verse 22. Then Peter took him aside to speak to him privately and began to reprove him and charge him sharply, saying, God forbid, Lord, this must never happen to you. But Jesus turned away from Peter and said unto him, Get behind me, Satan. You are in my way, an offense and a hindrance and a snare to me, for you are minding what partakes not of the nature and quality of God, but of men. Then Jesus said to his disciples, If any man desires to be my disciple, let him deny himself, disregard, lose sight of, and forget himself and his own interest, and take up his cross and follow him, follow me. Cleave steadfastly to me, conform wholly to my example in living, and if need be, in dying also. Anyway, on the Amplified version, I don't like that one which says, if need be. You know, the problem with the Amplified version, it goes around when it's speaking about something that is here, It goes round, you know, that one which is said in English, beating about bush. It goes round and round and round and round. Then it says, yeah. The King James say, just say, bop. It just picks up. So we thank God so much for the reading of His word.
Amen.
May God bless the reading of His word.
Hallelujah.
Now, this is a story of when Jesus was about to go towards His passion. And this story starts from verse 1 when you read chapter 16. And I have entitled this message, Don't Be an Offense.
All right.
Don't be an offense.
All right.
Now, an offense is something that comes to distract. An offense is a breach of the law or a custom. That is according to the British interpretation of English on the offense. But I like it on a Greek interpretation because that's where we derive our talking from. When the Bible was talking about an offense, it was talking about something that is coming as a snare. Something that is coming as a trap to trap you not to do what you are supposed to do. The purpose of a trap is that when an animal put their legs on the trap, they are trapped up and they are caught and they will not do anything.
Amen.
And then the owner of the trap will come and take the animal and go and enjoy the meat. So when Jesus was speaking to this man, let's begin with it. Jesus was talking to His disciples. And He says to His disciples, what do men say that I am? And the disciples began to speak, each one according to their interpretation of why men are speaking. But when He says, what about you guys? They were all quiet. And in their silence, the Bible says, Peter then stood up and said, you are the Christ, the Son of the living God.
Amen.
Then Jesus said, you did just say what you have said, but there is a mind that has come somewhere to reach up inside you and cause you to understand in another way better than your mind. So what you have said is not something that you have just thought with your own mind. You have heard it from my Father.
Amen.
He himself, Peter, did not understand it. Because when he was just speaking, he was just talking.
Yeah.
But Jesus knew.
Right.
And then they began to walk. And Peter now, if you remember, that's when he said, upon this rock I will build my church and I will do great things, you know. He spoke highly about him. And Peter now began to walk shoulders high. As he is walking shoulders high, Jesus continues to speak again. He says, yeah, I'm going to die, you know. The Bible says, where we have started to read, it says, after that, which means after the conversation that they did, and the great proclamation, that means when Peter had spoken, Jesus knew that these guys now know who I am, and my ability of what I can do. They are inspired now. Their mind are well set for me to go and die. They now understand everything.
Amen.
And now they are talking. You know, guys, when I die, I will rise again on the third day. And the inspiration came from Peter again. He is inspired. This time Peter did not talk.
I want you to watch this.
This time Peter did not talk. When all the disciples were there, the Bible says he took him aside. Every time when the devil is attacking, he will take you aside out of others. And then he will deal with you as an individual. Come on, clap your hands, church. Been anointed and his mind had just been captured. This is where I have said there is a doctrine walking around. It's walking, pastor. It's a doctrine that is walking around, telling people that when you are born again, it's over. You are supposed to go to just heaven and enjoy the heavens. There is no more deliverance. This deliverance thing is a lie. How many of you have ever heard that? That there is no need of deliverance when you are born again. But Peter was delivered. When he had just been inspired by God to speak, and he speak a great confirmation about Jesus, from there he is captured by the enemy. And he speaks now to Jesus, you know, you are a big man. You remember what I told you? I told you you are a big man anointed. So whatever you are telling us, it cannot happen. Now, I want you to watch this. That's why Jesus said you are an offense.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Glory.
This is your book, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let me read a little bit from this, your book. Youth for the Nations, a guide to youth leadership. I just want a statement that is there. Again, it's on page 15 for those who have got the book. Again, emotion may sound well when given verbally, but when examined more closely, errors are often found. It's coming from this book. He was talking about in a meeting of people of God.
Wow.
That somebody can stand up and say, I've got a point.
Sounds nice. Eh?
And the point may sound very nice and very good when you are talking. That everybody clap. Have you ever realized that in meetings, people like clapping hands? Hey, you have spoken. And the other one speaks against that one. Yeah, you have spoken. That's wonderful. That's the spirit of a meeting in leadership. So the Bible, then here where we have read now, when Babalu Papa was writing this one, he says, a point that can be said may sound very well, but when you closely examine the point, it will be carrying an error. Serious error. That can destroy the whole of the youth in Australia. Because of one point that has been said by one man. One man can destroy all the people. And inspires. Our brother spoke. Everybody begin to clap hands. Error. That has not been examined. So whenever you gather together, remember there is an error that can come up. So when Peter was speaking, he was inspired for an error that could have destroyed the whole logic and the purpose of the cross of Jesus.
Oh, yes. Amen. 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 Amen.
Peter is coming and Jesus says, you are in offense. In other words, what Jesus was saying is, you are a trap. You want to kill me. Not the killing of the cross, but the killing of destroying the work of God.
Oh, yes.
The killing of destroying the love of God. The purpose and the will of God.
Amen.
Because what you are speaking is true, that Jesus could have just called things in heaven to just come, whether fire or angels, whatever, he could call from heaven to destroy everything. Because he was anointed. That's why if you continue reading, where I finished the reading, he says, each man when you are coming, don't carry your things, the will of your body, but you must not do the will of the man. Oh, okay. Let's read that one, because there is a deliverance that I want to talk about there. Thank you, Jesus. Verse 24. But Jesus said to his disciples, if any man desires to be my disciple, Let him one deny himself. You have to deny yourself. In other words, you have to disregard yourself. You have to lose sight of yourself. That self thing. You must be delivered from men. Paul was delivered from men. If you read from the book of Acts, Paul says, I was delivered from men. There must be a deliverance from men because men bring pride to another man. So Jesus was going to carry pride in him. And our Father, what does he say? He says, if you want to prosper in your ministry, number one, pride. Number two, money. Number three, women or men. The other way around. So these are things that can kill you, and it's a deliverance from men that you must be delivered from.
That's right.
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
You remember we were talking to this woman? Yes. The woman that we were praying for. She's so connected to her people. That we try to tell her, don't do this, don't do this. She feels like, pastors are being cruel here. Because of a demon that is connecting her to men. To the people. If your friend says, I'm not going for you, you get connected and you say, I can also not go.
Amen.
If your friend says we are not giving money,
that's it.
And the good thing these days, we are having a bus. How many of you remember my message for the bus? Or somewhere you're not there. I was talking about the pastor, I was talking about the means of communication. The WhatsApp, what's down, what is it? And the Facebook and stuff like that. I told people, I said, those are buses. A bus does not ask you for an address, a postcode, and what are you putting on, and everything. Or what they can deny you if you want to get in naked. That's why when the bus can deny you, wrong address. But if you are just putting on your clothes and everything that is in you, it will just allow you to come in. Let's go, bring the ticket. Same applies with the issues of WhatsApp. And the Facebook and everything like that. There are some people who say, I don't WhatsApp, I don't Facebook, I don't do this. That one is a bus which is carrying information. The problem is you.
Okay.
What is important is the receiver and the sender.
Okay.
Oh yeah.
WhatsApp just carries, if you say, how are you? It just carries the how are you and put it there. It doesn't change.
No, it doesn't.
Unless the receiver on your phone has got a problem, then you can even see with the
you say my phone is broken.
So stop accusing each other with the WhatsApps and other things. Discipline your mind.
Amen.
What needs to be delivered is your mind. You have ever received a message? When was it, Mama, when you received that message which was supposed to come to me? Yesterday. And when she received the message, she had to message the person back and say, what do you mean? Because the message just came as raw as it was. It was not changed so that she can know. But the WhatsApp just carried the message and brought it to her. Sometimes we fight and we claim and say what up is bad, what down is bad, and other things and other. What is it? Facebook. We start to fight about Facebook. And discipline your mind. You need deliverance of the mind. Come on, you hear me? Because right now, if you want to WhatsApp someone while I'm preaching, you can do it. But it's you to honor it and say it's time of preaching. I can't do this.
Amen. 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 Amen.
Hallelujah.
One stone.
You need deliverance of the mind.
Amen.
Deliverance from the people. You need to be delivered. That's where you need deliverance.
Amen.
2011 was the year of deliverance.
Yes.
And our father was saying, you must know what you want to be delivered from.
Amen.
Don't just come all of yourself and say, deliver me. From what? Because what we have said is, what we have said is, there is positional sanctification.
Mm-hmm.
Where the Bible says, but to all who received him, he gave them power to become children of God. There is progressive sanctification. Where you continue to be saved,
okay.
You realize a problem and you say, now I have to work out this one.
Yes.
The problem is now, if we tell you something right now, you can be angry and go out angry.
Amen.
And you say, they were preaching about me. He was talking about me. They told him. They told him. Instead of repenting and say, God help me, I have been caught here. I need to be saved.
Woo.
I need salvation on this area.
Amen. Amen.
That's why we say deliverance is progressive.
Wow.
And some of the deliverances, they are not deliverances of laying hands and you fall down. That's why sometimes you complain, you say they are pushing us and stuff. But sometimes we will be forcing to say, let it go. Because I have seen a demon and you can't see it. You must know what you want to be delivered from. Our father, 1991, he was going around preaching, and I was a young man. I went to that conference miraculously. Some of you, I told you about it. When he preached, what did he say? He said, you must discipline your mind. Don't say, because I'm a youth, like what our brother was preaching here. Because I'm a youth, you know, I will be good when I get married. Oh, brother, you are cheating yourself. Make history when you are still young. If you go to Gunt where I grew up, they will tell you they still have my steps there.
Hallelujah.
They still know there was this brother from the Mtambiwas. If you go to Fort Detroit, they will first ask you, do you know Pastor Mtambiwa?
Yeah.
Because I did something when I was a young boy. I was ministering. I remember ministering my pastor because I didn't have money. You remember I said I was a chairman when I was a student. But I would go in the bush to cut firewood and bring it to my pastor for him to get something. There is no way that you can say, I can't minister, I can't do anything in the house of God. I'm a student, I'm like this. No. Let your mind be delivered.
Amen.
And the Bible says, let that mind which was in Christ Jesus be in you for you to be transformed. There is a system that people just carry because of flying all over like this. We have all flown somewhere. I've been everywhere. Better some of the places that we have never been. Don't be changed because of flying. I was. Who is it? That was it? You, Mama. I was talking to somebody. Say, this is the Australia. You know this Masofa thing. And I said to my wife, I think the Masofa thing people are not explained properly. To know how good it is to safeguard you.
Amen.
Amen.
Okay. This woman was my second. I went to Masofa first and to another woman. And some things happen. But the good thing is, It was something that was being handled by elders, leaders of the church. And when the scaffold happened, it didn't hurt anyone. But it just disappeared like that. God was preparing me for this wonderful wife. Because I think God was delivering me from men. When you are going there, it's for your advantage. So that when things are happening, if your girl says you don't have money, you go to Mama Elder and tell them, you know, she's saying I don't have money. Then Mama Elder will be able to go back and talk to the girl and say, you know, it will happen. You remember that girl, Mama? In Leeds. There's a girl who was saying, I can't be married by this one. And Mama Pastor said, don't believe on what you are seeing now. And now the boy is a big man now.
Huge and potential.
And him now, the girl is now just running, following. But when he came, he had nothing. And Mama Pastor had to work hard to say, just take it.
Amen.
You must be delivered from men.
Yeah.
You know what? Let me say this, Pastor. The other day, when we were young, there's a girl, she knows it. There's a girl, she was a very beautiful girl, and we were, you know, in youth, I know everything, you know. We were working together, and she was part of this other youth that does things. And she did a very big mistake. A brother who had nothing goes for her. I don't know if you know Kufonya. He goes for him, for the girl. And she stood up and said, she was telling us now. She said, stood up and said, look at me. And she went around. So she said, I said, do you think you and me can match? And the boy cried. Aww. And he went for another girl, they waited. But this one, who could not match? You know, this issue of that, just following what other youth are doing, and you are just following. You need deliverance so that you know where you are going.
Yes.
You need to be delivered from the spirit of men. Deliverance should show you direction as a young man. As a young boy, you must know what to do. As a young girl, you must know where to go. That must be your special deliverance. Your mind must be focused on Christ.
Amen.
Peter was delivered. He thought that everything, now I can say everything. There are some demons that come because of a certain place that they have put you.
Wow.
Oh, okay. Mm-hmm. They have said, they are now. And there are demons which come now. Oh, let's greet our national chairman. Wonderful. Because you are a national chairman, there are some demons that come to attack you because of the office.
Amen.
It's a demon that has nothing to do with you when you are dancing here before they chose you to be somewhere. It has nothing to do with you. But the moment you want to move,